Dig, what it do, man? Y'all know what it is already. It's your boy D, and welcome to the channel. And my line though, man, watch who you know, and know who the hell you watch. Let's get it.
Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe.
The warriors address it, they regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it. The warriors address it, they regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it.
Yo, it's your boy One More Again. Welcome to the channel. Am I lying though? It's your boy D. Y'all know what it is already, man. And before we get going, you already know. I'ma tell you. Watch who you know and know who you watching, man. Now, dig. The Young Dolph murder trial. Now, as we know, Young Dolph was murdered at a cookie spot in his hometown in Memphis, and he was going to get some cookies from the little joint. He knew the people or whatnot, you know what I mean, supporting businesses, you know what I mean, in the community where he's from or whatnot. And basically he was set up, you know what I mean, and my mans, you know what I mean, got they did that to him or whatever. Now they have people locked up for it. And there's a trial that's supposed to be starting, I want to say March of next year. Well, let me tell you what it says. Young Dolph murder trial. Judge recuses himself thanks to appeals court order. Now, when you recuse yourself, that means you take yourself, you know, out the game or whatnot, you know what I mean? But basically, he really didn't do it himself because it was an order from appeals court. Now, it says the Young Dolph murder trial has now have to find another judge to preside over the case per an appeals court order brought by the attorneys for one of the defendants. According to the Associated Press, Shelby County Criminal Court Judge Lee Coffey recused himself as of Friday, October 27, and asked the clerk of the court to assign a new judge to the high-profile case. Now, the recusal came as a result of a motion filed by Luke Evans, the lawyer for the co-defendant Justin Johnson, who claimed that Coffey couldn't be impartial after the judge failed to inform him about an order limiting Johnson's ability to communicate with people outside the jail other than Evans. Now, but Coffey also being confined, Coffey all but confined Johnson to administrative segregation, meaning that he would be denied like all privileges, y'all. Like no phone call, no visits. You can't get no letters. He can't send no letters. Other than, of course, you know what I mean, lawyer visits or whatever, until the disposition of the case. Now, as a result of the release of a song back in 22 called No Statements, which was reportedly recorded on a contraband cell phone. I don't doubt that, you know, that's possible, you know. But according to Evans, Coffey's order against his clients was punitive, right? Since he didn't let the defense know that he was issuing the order before he did so, and the appeals court agreed. Now, for y'all that don't understand that, a lot of times when they, like, push motions or they submitting, you know what I mean, and requesting certain particular thing, they have to actually inform the people of what they're gonna do. You know what I mean? So that kind of got in the way. Anyway, Coffey has set the trial date for March 11, 2024, I told y'all, but it's not clear whether this date will continue to stand now that he's recused himself, my bad, y'all. It's also not clear when a new judge will be named to preside over the case. So, with this trial supposed to be starting in 2024 in March, now they have to find a whole new judge for this particular trial. I'm not sure if them guys being tried together or separately. They may have different trials, you know. But according to Billboard, Johnson and his co-defendant Cornelius Smith has pleaded not guilty. They pleaded not guilty of the charges, including first-degree murder. A motive for the killing has not been disclosed yet, and which is crazy because it's like the streets is talking anyway, right? It hit a road, the case itself, it hit a roadblock over the summer when an individual whom law enforcement considered a person of interest was shot and killed, according to ABC 24. Joshua Taylor was found dead on the corner of Spotswood Avenue and Bunton Street in the Orange Mound District of Memphis. Authorities had no leads and as a result were asking the public for their help in identifying his potential killer or killers. Taylor, who also went by the name CEO Teezy, was first named as a person of interest in Dolph's murder in February 2022 alongside Devin Burns. But meanwhile, Johnson and Smith were arrested and accused of being the prime shooters. Both were given ultimatums to find defense lawyers, and according to the court documents, Smith, he actually obtained a lawyer while Johnson was appointed one. Now, you know, Johnson got that PD then. You know how that worked. They all worked together at the end of the day anyway. Now, at the time, Jamarcus Johnson, who was 26, was accused of helping two people, Justin Johnson, who was Jamarcus's brother, and Cornelius Smith, invade the police capture after Young Dolph's murder, pled guilty to conspiracy to commit first degree murder. But all in all, this is what I'm saying. Y'all have the people, y'all have witnesses. Well, one has been shot and killed or whatever, but y'all have enough to convict. So my question is, do y'all think this is a monkey wrench being thrown in a trial to postpone the trial to give them time to quote-unquote not find other witnesses, you know, for the Young Dolph's case? Or do y'all believe that this is something that's really, really going on and they really can't get the truth out of nobody? But, I mean, the streets know. The streets know what's going on. I'm going to tell you what I think. I think it's a play on money because you got to think about it. Whoever owns Dolph's estate at this moment, of course they're going to have crazy lawyer fees, right? And again, lawyers, PDs, DA, judges, bailiffs, even the lady that be typing on the funny typewriter, you know, they all know each other. They kick it with each other. You know what I mean? It's like, it's kind of like a game, so to speak. You feel me? Because they'll take the gloves off and fight like heck in the courtroom against each other. You know, the lawyer and the DAs. And then later, they kicking it at a party or something, or somebody's Thanksgiving dinner or christening or whatever. You feel me? And that's how they really, really do it. Like, if you see the what's that TV show? Like Law and Order and them cop shows. They really do that. They really, really fight hard against each other for two different clients and then go and have a drink with each other. So, I think it's a money play. Am I lying though? Make sure y'all like, subscribe, comment, man. And let's talk about it down there in them comments. And before you leave, please do not forget to hit that notification bell so you can get more of these content videos when I put these jokers up. And as always, before I get up out of here, man, love the life that you live and the loyalty that's within it. Hey, Goma, tell them what it is.
Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe.
The warriors address it, place up, regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it. The warriors address it, place up, regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it. The warriors address it, place up, regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it. The warriors address it, place up, regain order. The boss comes first, the rest is added on it. The